Dear students, welcome to another video session on implementation of combinational logic circuit using PLA. Before going to the implementation of PLA and problem solving on PLA, let us see the comparison between ROM, PROM, PLA and PAL, because in the later sessions we'll be implementing the combinational circuits using also PAL. Okay, so here you can see that we have compared three devices, your ROM, PROM, your PLA and PAL. So dear students, here we have compared these three devices or components based on the major changes that occurs in their structure, okay, and which is very useful for you all to solve the problem. Okay, so you can see that in ROM and PROM, the AND array is fixed and OR array is programmable. Okay, so the array which is fixed, that is the gates which is fixed for you all in case of your ROM and PROM, will be your AND gates, whereas the fixed AND OR gates is programmable. That is, the AND array is fixed over here and the OR array is programmable. Okay, in case of your PLA, that is programmable logic array, in case of your PLA, you can see that both your AND and the OR gates are programmable. Okay, so in case of PAL, the main difference between PLA and your programmable array logic, you can see the major difference is here the OR array is fixed and the AND array is programmable. Okay, so here your ROM and PROM is cheaper and simple to use, whereas your PLA is costliest and complex than PAL and PROMs. Okay, and your PAL is cheaper and simpler, okay, when compared to your PLA. Okay, so here all the minterms are decoded. Okay, here AND array can be programmed to get desired minterms. Okay, so these points which I am explaining to you all here will be more clear to you all when I solve the problem. AND array can be programmed to get desired minterms in case of your PAL. Okay, so only Boolean functions in standard SOP, sum of products form, can be implemented using PROM. Okay, any Boolean functions in standard SOP form can be implemented using your PLA. Here, any Boolean functions in SOP form can be implemented using your PLA. So we have seen the major difference between these three components. So let us go ahead with the problem in case of PLA. Let us implement the problem. So the question goes like this: a combinational circuit is defined by the functions. So the function f1 is given as summation of m 3, 5, 7, and f2, the function f2 has the summation of minterms 4, 5, and 7. So implement the circuit with a programmable logic array having 3 inputs, 3 product terms and 2 outputs. Okay, so they've asked us to implement this having 3 inputs, 3 product terms and 2 outputs. Okay, so let us see how to proceed. So this problem is quite simple. So the first step, what we'll have to do is we'll have to implement the Boolean functions. The simplification of the Boolean function is the first step. So in the first step, you can see that we have done the simplification of the Boolean function using our Karnaugh map. See here, they have clearly mentioned as the minterms. So f1 having the function of minterms 3, 5 and 7. So that I have plotted that. And again f2 has 4, 5, 7. Okay, so you can see that it's a 3 variable one. So 3 variable K map I have plotted. And I have marked R3, R5 and 7. Okay, so you will have two groups. Okay, the grouping one I can do like this, having this one and this one, and second group being like this, the horizontal group. Okay, so the expression which I end up is f1 is equal to AC. Okay, AC, here I have a A and the common term over here is 1 and that 1 is C. So AC plus BC. So here, so BC is my 1 and 1 is BC. So going back to my F2, when I group, I get two groups. So this one has one group, another group being this. Okay, so I have two groups, so I get two mean terms. So that being A B dash plus A C. Okay, so we can see here we have actually here we have AC as one product term, BC as another product term. Here for F2 we have AB bar as one product term and AC as another product term. So totally if you see our AND gate terms are four actually, right? So if we are eliminating the redundant terms, then I can say that we have three AND products, right? So those are AC, because AC is repeated over here. Okay, so I'll consider it as one min term. So AC is going to be my one min term and BC is going to be my second product term and my third product term being AB dash. Okay, so there is three min terms. Okay, now as I told you, we identified three product terms, right? So let me write this in a PLA program table, and the same can be represented in a circuit also. So writing in my PLA table, I have three columns here actually, one representing my inputs. I've written it as 1, 2, 3. So we have identified our three inputs, AC, BC and AB dash. Okay, so I've written the three product terms over here. And my inputs A, B and C, my three inputs, I have written it here. Okay, and because these are the inputs covering my product terms, and obviously we know the outputs, which is nothing but our F1 and F2, right? So AC, if you're considering AC, we have the product term 1, right? So AC, so our inputs A and C is enable, right? We have put a 1 across A and C, and this AC comes in our F1 function, also in F2 function. We saw that AC was a repetitive term, right? You can see here our AC was a repetitive term in F1 as well as in F2, right? So that is represented over here. Okay, I've written a 1 and 1 both under F1 and F2. So coming to BC, my second product term, so I'll be writing a 1 across my B and 1 across my C, right? And this BC is falling under my function F1. So under F1, I'll write a 1 here, right? So coming to my third product term, AB dash, so A will have a 1 and B dash is nothing but complement of 1, so that will be a 0. So 1 under A and B bar will be 0. The value of B bar is complement of 1, so 0 under B. Okay, so this comes under my function F2. Okay, so both of these columns are filled according to the, you know, existing product terms with the values 1 and 0 that specifies my conditions, which is said to be as true. Okay, so students, this is how we implement, you know, the programmable logic array. So any expressions given, okay, you have to follow the steps of plotting the K-map, identifying, you know, the mean terms, the inputs and outputs, and finally you can write the programmable table with the PLA, and the same thing can be drawn also. Hope you all have understood. Thank you.